Okay, I recently found myself in an AI battle between MidJourney and Adobe Photoshop Beta's new Generative Fill AI that it has. And really what it comes down to is I had an image that I made in MidJourney and I accidentally entered the wrong aspect ratio. So I needed to see which one of these AI programs will give me the same image but fix the aspect ratio better. Let's go ahead and look at how to do it in each of the programs and you can decide who won the battle. All right, so here I'm in MidJourney with the image that I want to do. And the problem I have is I have a square image and I want to make it a 16:9 ratio because I want to make this a YouTube thumbnail. Now I need to change the aspect ratio. I want to show you first how to do that in MidJourney. Now the key is you want to come up here before you do this and you are going to go ahead and upscale your image. You are working with the upscale image. Then it gives you this version. And the other next thing you want to do is you just want to go hashtag settings. Make sure you hit that twice. And then boom, you're going to get your settings to pop up right here. Now the key is this, you're going to want to make sure that you have remix mode click. That is the key to making sure you can come back and do this. Once you do that, it's very, very simple. I'm going to come back up here to my image. And now what I want to do is I'm going to go to make variations. And what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to do an aspect ratio of 16:9. I'll go ahead and submit that. Okay, and bam, now you have a 16:9 aspect ratio of this image. But there's a couple of issues here if you look at how MidJourney does it. The first thing is this is a very specific animation. And if I click it up, you'll see the first thing I did, it actually stretched my image out, which is not what I wanted. The other thing that it did is it did add some changes to my original elephant. So even though I was able to use MidJourney to take this image and make it the proper aspect ratio, I didn't get to preserve the image that I wanted. Let's go ahead and take the same image and see what Photoshop can do with it. Okay, so now I'm here in Photoshop and what I'm gonna do is I did copy that from MidJourney. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna paste it in there. You can see my image. And now I wanna make this 16:9. And if you wanna make sure you're definitively getting something 16:9, you need to come up here to the crop tool and in this ratio pull down, you'll see some options. And I'm gonna do a 16:9 ratio because I want to make sure that's exactly what I'm getting. So I'm just going to expand my crop tool, make sure I'm getting that. I'll hit enter. And now you can see I have a 16:9 crop. So now I'm going to do is take my rectangular marquee tool and I'm just going to select the background that I want to do. And now what I'm going to do, let's just do a generative fill here and see what we get. Bam, that is pretty impressive. You can see we got some options there. We have a window. That's really cool too. I like that. The plants, I think maybe this kind of like that. And now I'm going to do the other side. And while this thing's running, one reason why I'm doing a generative fill in Photoshop that I like to do each section individually is kind of like I have the options that I can actually mix and match them. If I do them both at the same time, I'll have to deal with whatever gets me. But doing each side helps me with the pixels and lets me get a little more options when I'm doing this. So you can see, let's see what it did with this rock. Oh, that's funky. Oh, that's kind of nice. I would have to say I kind of like this rock here as well. So, you know, taking a look at this 16:9 aspect ratio change in a Photoshop beta versus what I got over here in Discord, you can obviously see just a gigantic difference between how the two goes. So as you can see, in my opinion, there is absolutely no doubt which one of these absolutely wins for changing the aspect ratio once you've created something in MidJourney. Photoshop blows MidJourney out of the water in this particular aspect. So if you are in a position where you have created an image that you really like in MidJourney, but you need to change the aspect ratio, you need that flexibility, my advice is to go ahead and bring that image into Photoshop beta and take advantage of that incredible generative fill that is now in Photoshop. Anyway, guys, I hope that was helpful. I'd love to hear what you had to say with this. Leave me notes and comments down below. And yeah, go out there, keep on shooting. And yeah, I'll talk to you soon.